about the city depreciation, breaking the cycle of the depreciation of the city. We've seen the city rising. Some say after the vice president visited India and got back, he's brought some magic wand. It's rising like that. Well, Media General wants to do an intellectual conversation on this tomorrow, and I've been joined in the studio by the head of news planning here at Media General, Sedem Ofori. Sedem, welcome. Thank
Pleasure
you very
to
much
be here.
For your time.
Thanks for having
What's
me.
Happening tomorrow? Tomorrow, what are we expecting as
well,
usual?
Tomorrow, we're having a big conversation around the city, and the conversation will be focused around finding a solution to this cycle of depreciation which the city suffers.
Okay.
In fact, now it's becoming even consistent, the period of depreciation.
Okay.
Because over the last 7 years, it appears to fall between January and March.
Okay.
There are so many reasons that have been given by people for that. But is there a way we could stem this tide? Is there a way we could prevent this from happening again in future, given the adverse impact it has on businesses, on investment, etc.?
So that's what we're doing tomorrow.
Yes.
Who are our guests tomorrow? Well, going to dissect and bisect everything?
We have quite an interested, I should say impressive,
share with me
of
your
speakers.
Details.
These are people who command industry respect. First, we have Mr. Kwame Pienim, who's a renowned economist.
Okay.
He begs no introduction. He will be one of the speakers on the program.
Right.
We also have Dr. Otin JC, former president of the Association of Ghana Industries, himself also having so many business interests, tropical cables, etc. These are people who, aside from having an intellectual or cognitive knowledge, they also are practitioners in the field. They're on the ground working. So they can bring some real practical industry experience to bear on the issue. We have Mr. Ken Thompson, CEO, Bilex
Finance.
Yes. He's also a speaker. Then Mr. Emmanuel Asiedumante, who is a former deputy governor
of
the Bank of Ghana. He will bring the central bank's policy aspects to the conversation.
Interesting. The first one we had, the economic dialogue series on the Ponzi scheme, was the talk of town.
It was.
People drew a lot of inspiration from it. What is this one supposed to achieve?
Well, you know, the Media General Economic Dialogue series is that platform where we have detailed, practical, solution-oriented conversations around business. So all the economic challenges that impact on you and I, it is the seminal platform for the conversations to be had on that, solution-oriented. What we intend to achieve with this is that these speakers coming to the program with the wealth of experience that they have, the industry experience, the understanding of how the global market works and its impact on the local economy, they'll be able to proffer solutions to the problems that we have. It's a really an ambitious topic, seeking to stem the
tide,
seeking for an economy that has been described as import-driven. And yet we want to explore ideas of how we can stem the tide of depreciation. So it really would be an audacious program. It's where you're going to be hearing unconventional ideas and approaches to solving the problem of depreciation of the city, and ideas that are sustainable. I know there have been a number of ideas by the people who manage our fiscal space, the injection of some money to stem the tide for a period of time. But we're looking for sustainable long-term impact. It's been said that the city is already doing well against other currencies, but that won't reverse the cost it has had, the impact it has had on businesses who had to do trading at a time when the currency was low, who had to find more cedis just to go and buy a few dollars in order to be able to buy things for their shelves. Those inventory have not been exhausted. So the prices will still be high, and it's going to have implications on us. We're looking for long-term sustainable solutions to this depreciation.
Where are we meeting tomorrow?
It's happening at Executive Theater of TV3. And it's happening from quite early in the day, 8 a.m.
8 a.m. sharp.
Because it's a breakfast.
We're starting the business day with it.
Yes, we're starting the business day with it. So we urge the public to be here on time.
Do they pay to enter?
No, it's free. It's open to the public. You know, our programs usually are the behest. It's for the service of the public. So we open our doors to the public. But our seats are limited. So we urge the public to be here on time.
I see. So Executive Theater tomorrow, 8 a.m. We're starting four speakers. And we're talking about breaking the cycle of the city's depreciation. Who can attend?
The general public is
everybody
invited.
Students.
But we extend a particular invitation to those who, currency dealers, people who trade directly with our currency. Of course, that's an impact on all of us.
Okay.
But there are primary people who, on a day-to-day basis, have to do dealings with the Ghana cedi and then also with foreign currency. We urge you to be here. Importers, exporters, spare parts dealers, etc. This is your forum. Be here to be a part of the conversation that finds solutions
will
to
it be
the problem. It would be live on TV3. It will also be live on 3FM and across all Media General news platforms. But it's nothing quite like being at the venue. You know, sometimes when we go off television, that is when the real conversations begin on the ground.
Yeah. Okay, Senator, I thank you very much for your time. So the deal is done. The date is set tomorrow, Thursday. We're meeting at the Executive Theatre, TV3 at Desa Wikanda, and it's at 8 a.m. We're talking the economic dialogue series. We're talking about how to break the cycle of depreciation of our Ghanaian cedi. It started rising, but can we sustain it? That's the question we want to ask. And we're bringing you all the aspects, the managers of the economy, everybody else who has experience to deal with the thing. My name is Jeremy Hughes. On behalf of the rest of the team, Bright Nanamfo, Dr. Nanama Ajiman, and their back end staff, will say thank you. And as always, as I say, if you can think it and your heart can believe it, only you can achieve it. See you tomorrow. I'm gonna dance right now.